And let's bring in Greg Autry, who's joining us from Cape Canaveral in Florida. He's a space policy expert and a professor at Arizona State University's Thunderbird School of Global Management. Great to see you. Your thoughts on the flight, first of all, what it means, what it achieved.
Well, for me personally, you know, I was on the runway at Mojave, California in 2004 when Sir Richard announced Virgin Galactic, and I have engaged and followed with the effort ever since. So this is important for me too. I'm so happy to see the success and the tenacity and persistence that that he has applied payoff for him, for the team and the company. But this is going to be a seminal moment in human history. This is a tipping point where we're not just leaving the planet with a government program and a few quasi-military people. This is the moment that humanity really begins our expansion out of the atmosphere.
That's an interesting way of putting it, because, you know, and let's get the, you know, the sort of negativity, if you like, out of the way, because people are saying things like that, you know, this is a couple of rich guys playing with toys no one else can afford. But you have an argument against that.
Certainly. First of all, every great invention that we've had in the past was originally something that, only the wealthy could afford. I remember paying $1,200 for my first CD player. That's not the point. The point is that they're putting their money, their private capital, into something that's going to make the world better for all of us. And secondly, by getting a lot of people up there and seeing, I've had the opportunity to be friends with a number of astronauts, and when they come back, they're changed. They see the world with no borders. They see that thin atmosphere and realize how precious our biosphere is. Getting a bunch of wealthy and powerful people to experience that transformative awareness is hugely valuable.
And space does have implications for climate change in a good way. We've learned a lot about climate change from space, right?
Absolutely. We wouldn't know anything about climate change without space data from NASA and NOAA. Solar power was developed in great extent by NASA and DOD for satellites. GPS makes every transportation system on Earth more efficient, saves more CO2 emissions and other emissions than any technology that's ever been developed. To pretend that investing in space is not the right thing to do for our environment is incredibly short-sighted.
I wanted to ask you if you thought that this is a sustainable business in terms of, you know, profitability and that eventual accessibility for ordinary people, and also what are the implications for future commercial flights?
Yeah. So a lot of people have said, you know, this only lasts, everybody that's super rich will go a couple times, then it'll be done, or there'll be an accident, it'll stop. And I say, look at what's happening on Mount Everest. Every year, hundreds of people are going. They've had to put ladders in order to get them through faster. And when you do that, you actually march apparently by the frozen dead bodies of people that that went before. And it costs hundreds of thousands of dollars to mount this campaign. So I don't think you'll see anything different here, except that space tourism is much more pleasant and safer than that.
Wow, yeah. It was interesting to see Branson had kids there as part of the media briefing, and it struck me that's been important to him the whole way through, inspiring kids to take an interest in space and its potential.
I do have to say I've had the opportunity to speak to all three of the billionaires involved here at one time or another, and of them, Sir Richard's been by far the most sincere and passionate about what this means for the future of our planet and our people. And that just shines through every time you see him.
Greg Autry at the Kennedy Space Center, really great to speak with you. Certainly a momentous day, as you say. Really appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you.